Nollywood actress Biodun Okeowo is about to join her other colleagues in the industry who are married. What's up, my people? How na day? Just like the saying goes, the dream of every woman is to get married and have kids. Though we know that there are other people who want to live a celibacy life, but actress Biodun Okeowo said not in her own situation, because a lot of people, a lot of fans have been looking up to her and asking who is gonna be the lucky man. So without wasting much of your time, guys, she took to her Instagram page to let the world know that she has finally said yes to the man of her dream. And according to her post, she wrote, "From the unexpected trembling in my hands to the overwhelming rush of emotions, I couldn't hold back the tears of joy as he got down on one knee and asked me to be his forever. In that surreal moment, surrounded by love and filled with happiness, I said yes to the man of my dreams. Yes to the beautiful journey ahead as we embark on our forever together. Ademi." All right, so guys, like they say, he who finds a wife finds a good thing, and she who finds a man also finds a good thing. But we know how the celebrity marriage matter be, eh? I'm talking about the rate of divorce almost among all the celebrities, and that is why it did. I still have friends who keep saying that they can never marry a celebrity. Anyway, I hope that and I pray that our own marriage will be among the lasting ones, like that of Betty Doce, like that of Olu Jacobs and other legends in the industry. In this life, my people, just have money, and if you have the opportunity, also have that fame. In the video, I also don't know why she didn't show us the guy's face. Even in the picture, she was just covering the guy's face. I mean, the guy backed the camera. I mean, she don't go snatch person your husband. I beg go so that if she does that, then that means that is the genesis of her own marriage palaver. And also, I hope that she will make and do the right thing by him and not come back to social media to chase clout. Finally, they say there is no late comer in marriage. This I say to educate those who disturb others with the question, when are you going to marry? Or those who are commanding others, go and marry. So guys, this is where I'm going to end the gist. Please like this video and subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.
So ladies and gentlemen, normally, now small people like this, now they spoil yash. Small people like this, now they spoil the entire body. Anthony Joshua will be saying, all of us the canvas for. We be saying, I don't even come outside this morning to call jubilee, to call happy, to call congratulate. Don't go disgrace us. Don't go embarrass us publicly. The boy don't show, say he no be Nigeria. Say he no be part of us. Most of them go don't see the video where they trend now. Where we say after the fight where Anthony Joshua defeat Francis Ngannou, they give a microphone. The boy appreciates Cameroonian. He appreciates in UK people. He appreciates US people. He can't appreciate Saudi Arabia people. He can't ignore in country, in fatherland. The other time when I come outside to come talk about Manuel Akanji, this guy, where he draw the tattoo of NFF for body without playing for this country, where he ignore the country, people come for me where? People come where for me? When I don't see him now, this is the example. This is an example of some of them. Fire, I know say some people go talk say na Nigerians cause am. Na waiting na don't do the guy before na he cause am. I no one know waiting one cause am. The guy no suppose ignore Nigeria like that. Fine, Nigeria is a country of over 200 million people. You cannot expect everybody to like you. The few people will like you, try appreciate them. Anthony Joshua appreciate Cameroon, like say na from Cameroon he come from. Appreciate British, appreciate US. He can't give a big shout out to Saudi Arabia people. He ignore his country. He ignore his source. This boy come from Ogun State. Now why they talk the other time? Say I get double respect, triple respect for players in the likes of Alex Iwobi. We say they come this country to want to play for us. Fine, now we come outside that time. Come talk say the guy no play well. But now we don't see the importance of most of this guy. Despite everything we Nigerians do to them. if any match come tomorrow now, Alex Iwobi will still come this country to come play again. Those guys are indeed legend. This guy fight finish, win finish, go carry British flag, UK flag, now he carry. Ignore Nigeria, of which was not like that before. I no one know what the people want to do. I know say now some Nigerians now they cause them. But I no one know what the people want to do you. You are not supposed to ignore the entire Nigeria. Anthony Joshua, you don't mess up. If there's going to be a rematch tomorrow, someone like me, I'm going to canvass again and again for Francis Ngannou. Because Francis Ngannou can never win that game and not appreciate his people. As a matter of fact, up till now, the guy never changed his nationality. He never changed his nationality. He carried that Cameroon for head. But because of saying I don't get outside, because of saying I don't get money, because of saying I don't get the fame, when I don't get the stay, they don't see you as legend for that place. You can't ignore the entire country. So some of them go come outside, come to talk, say, now our own, it's not our own again. You don't prove him now. Say it's not part of us again. I know say some of them will still come for me, but try listen the matter way. The guy mentioned Cameroon, mentioned England, mentioned US. Can't end them with Saudi Arabia. No single shout out for Nigeria. And now we no sleep. All of us, you can only go to post you up and down. We no say nothing where we do. Where if you add to your credibility, you don't get the fame, you don't get the name. You don't forget your roots.